Hello，Let's have a look of the lab 8. So in the lab 8, we need to design two different gestures and then discover how the hand gesture affects the signal strength of the Wi-Fi. If you have time, you can have a check of this paper at first, so you got some idea. You don't need to read the whole paper, but you can have a look of the abstract at first, so you got the idea. You can check the Y-gest and the Y.3.0. These two are pretty famous on the gesture recognition with the Wi-Fi signal. I have sent a link into the our chat. You can have a look, especially the Y.3.0. It's pretty clear and easy to understand. Yeah, and they do have some source code that you can play with. But just come back to the lab 8. We need to design two different gestures and then have a look of the ISSI. How about let's have a look of how to collect the data at first. So if you still remember how to draw the Wi-Fi ISS pattern. I assume you are using the Windows, so we need to use this one, network monitor. The first step is to select Wi-Fi only, because we only care about the Wi-Fi signals, and you can start the capturing. But before that, you need to make sure you have already connect your computer with your let's say mobile phone as your mobile hotspot, and then place them be between you. I mean, let me draw something here. We need to put your mobile phone in here, and then you just stand in front of the mobile phone, and here is your laptop. Then you can wave your hand in front of the mobile phone or the computers. It's okay. Depends on you. You can face forward this side and wave your hand and have a look of the signal strength. So that's the lab 8. Let's go back to the screen. Okay, so open the network monitor and then press the stop button. So you can see the packets over here. Then you can start to wave your hand. For example, I am waving my hand and for a few seconds, and then I stopped, and then I wave my hand again, and then I wave a few seconds, let's say 3 seconds, and then I wave my hand again. And I continuously perform this gesture for 1 or 2 minutes. Then I press the stop button and I can output this one to my ESSER file. Then we can use the Wireshark to load it, just like what have we done in lab 2. Just use the Wireshark and then open it. So you can see the signal strength. Before we output as a plot, we need to apply a signal. So it's IPSRC, I think. IP.SRC equal to this. Going here, I have 53 packets. But as you can see here, the gesture is not that good because the signal strength didn't change a lot. It's around 51 and it doesn't have significantly changed. I think this is because my router is too far from my PC and I'm not able to move it around because it's a desktop. But when you're doing this one, you need to use your mobile phone as your hotspot so you can move it around and find the like great way, great distance, and then perform the gesture. But don't worry, I will show you later how to do this one. I will bring an Arduino with my mobile phone and let's have a check of the signal strength. But in here, I just want to show you what is the steps. So the first step is to use the network monitor to collect the packets. And then we come to the Wireshark, apply a filter and have a look of the signal strength. If you think this one is good, then you can output it. Just export as CSV file, like what we did in the lab 2. And then we can use the CSV file to plot the signal. We can plot the pattern, but this one is not that good. So what you want to see is like a pattern when you wave your hand. And the x-axis should be the time and y-axis should be the signal strength. And then you put this plot into your report and attach with this one. With a screenshot of Wireshark. And that's it. So now you've got the idea how to do this one. So let's have a look how to design a gesture. Because use the network monitor, it's not that easy to discover the pattern. So I am using my Arduino to do it. Give me a sec. I have already written down this script. It's basically just keep printing the Wi-Fi ISSI value. And let me send this one to my Arduino. So you don't need this one, but we are just using this one to discover the signal strength with the gesture. Okay, then we can use the plotter. No, it's an error. I need to close it at first, I think. No, let me restart it. Sorry. Okay, so I think I need to open my hotspot. I'm waiting for the connection. So I am using my mobile phone as the hotspot, and then I use the Arduino, which is just, you can consider this one as just a small computer, and connect to my personal hotspot. And let's see what will be the output. So now you can see we have some output on the screen. It's real-time signal strength over here. So let me just put them together very close to each other. So they are attached with each other. The Arduino just next to my mobile phone. And we can see the signal strength is minus 15 or 14. It's around here. Then I move my mobile phone away, like 1 meter away. And you can see the signal strength dropped to minus 60. Then I have some space to perform the gesture, right? If you don't have any idea like how to perform a gesture, you can have a check of this website, YDA 3.0. You can go to here. You have some visualization of the gesture. For example, the sweep. So I am going to perform this gesture and let's check what is the signal strength pattern in here. So I am doing nothing right now. And the pattern is looks like this. And then from now, I start to sweep between these two devices. Can you see the difference? So I'm keep sweeping. And then I stopped. Okay, so you should be able to see here this pattern. So from here, from this part, sorry, from this part, I am sweeping. And then in here, I'm just stopped sweeping. So you can see the pattern is different. So we just put it here. And then what's the next gesture? I can try an easy one. Push and pull, I think. This one, how about this one? Push and pull. So I'm doing nothing right now. Let's just wait. I didn't do anything. And now I start to perform push and pull. And then I stopped. So you can see the push and pull button. No, it's not button, just pattern. It's like this. And in here, I stopped doing the gesture, but I don't know why the gesture looks like this. But as you can see, they do have two different pattern, but we may need more like data to show it. So you may need to collect this gesture pattern for 1 or 2 minutes, and then you need to compare. I would say probably this one is a push and pull, and this one is a push and pull. So you need to figure out what is the pattern for specific gesture. And then put this one into your report. So this one is the real-time signal strength. But actually, you don't need to have this device, as I said before. All you need to do is just open the network monitor and start capturing like this. And then you start start to wave your hand in front of your mobile phone or your computer. And then you output to the Wireshark, then to Excel or other stuff to plot this pattern and have a check of it. And that's it. So in the submission, you need to show what is your hand gestures. For example, you are using sweep and push and pull, then you can put the pictures, or you can draw some pictures or something. You can upload a video if you want. And then question two, you need to show the screenshot showing the ISS values. And then, so it's a Wireshark screenshot. You can come to here. Come to here, then you can check the time. This screenshot should be fine. So we can know that the interval is around 1 second. So this one is not pretty good. As you can see, we are missing some data over here. So make sure you have enough packets and they are connected with each other. So you may want to play a video or play a music when you collect the data, so you can increase the traffic. The last thing is plot the RSS time series. Just something like this, but this one is absolutely a failure. So your patterns should have some like distinct pattern for each one, and you can specify at which time you perform this gesture, like I did. So that's the lab 8. You can start to read this paper or have a look of this website at first, and then collect the data. You can collect one of the gesture data and see how it works. If it doesn't work, you can let me know. Then we can have a look. Okay. Yeah. So if you have any question, just let me know. Or if you miss anything, I can show you again. I'm stop sharing right now. So if you have any trouble, you can share your screen or type it. You have a question about project submission, right? What is the question?
My project report is like currently 3,165 words, but that is like including the references
I think,
and like the table of
okay.
contents and
Yeah, I got your idea. So don't worry about this, like the limit about the words. It's just an instruction. You will not lose any marks if you exceed or less than that. But just like try to close that amount if you can. So don't worry too much, because we just want you to make it clear. So we think like probably 2,000, 3,000 can make everything simple and clear. Yeah, but if you exceed, don't worry too much. But if you can, you can just make it like shorter. But if you do not have that much, it's okay if you think you make everything pretty like clear.
Yeah.
And understandable. Yeah. So don't worry too much about the limitation. We will not be very strict on the words. It's not a writing task.
Yeah. Yeah, okay. Because like with the references and like all the subheadings and the table of contents as well, they take up some words. But other than that,
okay.
It should be fine.
Yeah, it should be fine. Don't worry. We will not be very picky on this part.
Yeah. And also, my demo video is like 53 MB, so it should be okay to just upload to Moodle.
Yes, that would be great.
Yeah.
So if you can play if see and see if it's clear, because we want the demo video is clear on the like pictures, or if you think it's not clear, you can upload a clear version to YouTube or Google
Drive. Yeah,
yes,
okay.
And you just attach the link in your report, and that should be fine.
Yeah.
But we will check the Moodle at first.
Yeah, okay. Because like the Moodle submission says 200 MB maximum,
yes,
for all files. So
yes,
I think if my video is 53 MB, it should be fine to upload.
Yeah, it should be fine. Should be fine.
Okay.
Definitely.
Hey Ray, just had a quick question for you. Could you move me to a breakout room so I could ask you it specifically?
Yes. What kind of question?
Just about the assignment.
Okay. Yeah.
It's more to do with code. That's why I'm asking to be put in a breakout room.
Okay, I see. Let me check how to create one. I create a room for that.
Yeah, I can join a breakout room.
Yeah, so but we want to make it quick because other students are waiting here.
So, sure.
So we spend around 5 minutes.
Yeah, there, 5 minutes will be fine. Yep.
Okay, thanks for the waiting. Now I'm back. If you have any trouble with the lab or the assignment, feel free to ask.
When will we be able to check our marks for lab 6 and lab 7?
I think before Friday,
okay.
Which is tomorrow.
Okay.
Yeah, so you can decide to do this or not, but this one is pretty fun. Even you have full marks for every labs, you can have a try of it, but you don't need to worry about the marks.
Okay.
Yeah, of course, if you have time. I know it's pretty busy for everyone.
Yeah, last week.
Yeah, it's a lot of assignments.
Hello, Ray. Hello.
Hello.
Can I ask a question about the project?
Yes.
Can I submit the type JupyterFile? Can I submit the JupyterFile as my program?
Yes,
as
you my can. Code? Yeah, Jupyter Notebook, right?
Yeah. It's okay, right?
Yeah, it is okay.
And for the demo video, do I need to go to the real environment to do experiment?
Yes, you need to try it in the real world scenario.
Can I just collect data from the real environment and then process this data and predict it in my home?
But does it have any difference? I mean, if you can collect the data, why not just run the stuff over there?
Because my roommate is the COVID is positive, you know. I'm isolating my home, so I can't.
I think you can send an email to Mahab and ask for extension because you cannot do this one. So just send an email and about it, and it should be fine.
But I collect. Can I use the data sets that I collected before to use it as to test the data?
Yeah, that's one of the requirements. But we also need to test on the real world scenario. So that's two different things. We need to like do both of them. But yeah, probably just send the email. We can give you extension or give you the permit that do not do the reverse scenario part.
Okay.
So we can discuss with the Mahab later.
Okay, yeah. I will send email.
Yeah. We'll talk about this issue to the professor. Don't worry.
Yeah, thank you.
Hi Ray, I had a quick question.
Yeah.
I just wanted to show you my code. Could you put me in a breakout room again, please?
Okay. Let me create one.
Thank you.
Okay, I'll be back in 5 minutes. I am about to close the meeting. Do you have any questions?
Oh, no.
Okay, no problem. So if you have any trouble with the assignment, just come to the help session. We have help session tomorrow.
Tomorrow, what time?
Check.
Let me check.
It's afternoon.
Afternoon. I think it's too late.
Mm-hmm. It's okay. So if you have any like issue, just try to.
Okay. Yeah.
Try to go to the help session. It's still before the due. And yeah, if you any issue like you need to apply for special consideration. For the assignment, you can also send an email to me at my hub.
So okay.
So we can take a note.
Yeah. All right, Julie. Thank you.
Okay. See you.
See you.